Marhaban, ahlan wa sahlan bikum. Welcome again to our Gateway to Arabic series with me, Dr. Imran Hamza Alawiye. Today's lesson, let's continue learning our vocabulary using the root letter system. And today's letters are Sheen, Ghain, and Lam. Shaghala, yashghalu. That's a verb to be busy, to work, to preoccupy with something. Sentences, please, so we can understand it better. Ishghal, ishghal awqata faraghika bil umur al mufida. Ishghal awqata faraghika bil umur al mufida. Occupy your free time with useful things. Yes. Ishghal awqata faraghika bil umur al mufida. Next. La tashghal nafsaka bima la fa'idata fihi. La tashghal nafsaka bima la fa'idata fihi. Do not occupy yourself with what is useless. Yep, something has no value. So do not occupy yourself with what is useless. لا تشغل نفسك بما لا فائدة فيه. اشغل بعض أوقاتك في خدمة آخرين. اشغل بعض أوقاتك في خدمة الآخرين. Spend and occupy some of your time in the service of others. نعم. اشغل بعض أوقاتك في خدمة الآخرين. نعم. Next. رحم الله من شغله عيبه عن عيوب الناس. May the mercy of God be upon he who preoccupied himself or herself with her or his own failings rather than other people's flaws, shortcomings. Yeah. رحم الله. رحم الله من شغله عيبه عن عيوب الناس. نعم. Next, let's go for a noun coming from this root letter. That's شغل. شغل means work, job. So we can say هذا شغل شريف. هذا شغل شريف. This is a noble job. نعم. هذا شغل شريف. Or we can say هذا الشغل لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع. هذا الشغل لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع. This job of yours, this job is a non-job. It will neither nourishes or avails hunger. It won't feed you. هذا الشغل لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع. نعم. ابحث عن شغل جديد. ابحث, search for new job. ابحث عن شغل جديد. Then you can tell me where to go. You can just say هذا ليس من شغلك. هذا ليس من شغلك. This is none of your business. Off you go. I don't need your advice. هذا ليس من شغلك. روح روحوا عني. Come on, disappear. Go away. Subhanallah. Okay. Now, or you can calm down a bit and say, على فكرة, by the way, هل لديك أي شاغر؟ على فكرة, by the way, هل لديك أي شاغر؟ Do you have any vacancy? شاغر. Or you can say, هل لديك أي شغل؟ Do you have any job? I can say, no. Okay, next, let's move on. What about the ismu fa'il, active participle from these roots letters? That shaghilun. Shaghilun mean what occupies people, for instance. So we can say, shughuli shaghilu. شغل الشاغل هو التعلم والتعليم. My passion, my preoccupation is learning and teaching. Yes, every day I feel like I'm trying to learn something new and I try to teach people whatever little that I know. شغل الشاغل هو التعلم والتعليم. Now, okay, let's look at the passive participle, which is مفعول. مشغول. مشغول, somebody's busy. مشغول. So you can say, هل أنت مشغول الآن يا عمران? Are you busy now, عمران? I can say, نعم, أنا مشغول جدا الآن. I'm very busy now. كما ترى, أنا في منتصف تدريس على الشابكة. As you can see, I'm in the middle of teaching online. في منتصف تدريس على الشابكة. And I can say, المشغول لا يشغل. المشغول لا يشغل. Somebody's already busy. Should not be. Nobody should pile up on them another job. They should not be disturbed. المشغول لا يشغل. نعم. Okay. What else? We can say ما لي أراك اليوم مشغول البال. ما لي أراك اليوم مشغول البال. Why do you, I see you very anxious today? You looks very preoccupied. What's going on? ما بك? What's up? ما لي أراك اليوم مشغول البال. Why I see you a little bit, you know, preoccupied. Okay, all right then. Like I said, don't worry, it's just life. Life is playing its game on me. Allah Kareem. Okay, let's move to another shade of meaning we can get from this shin, rain, and lam. And that's form two. Form two is shaghala yushaghilu. And you people shadda on the second root. Shaghala yushaghilu tashghil. And that's a verb to employ somebody or to operate something like a machinery. So you can say, for instance, شغل السيارة. That's mean turn on the car, start the car. شغل السيارة. Or شغل الضوء. That's mean turn on the light. Yeah? Okay, that's شغل يشغل. Another sentence we can make up is هل اكتشفت بعد كيف تشغل حاسوبك الجديد؟ هل اكتشفت بعد كيف تشغل حاسوبك الجديد. Have you figured it out yet how to operate your new computer? Having spent a lot of money on it. Now, that's me. Computer, I don't know. Nope. هل اكتشفت بعد, بعد means yet. هل اكتشفت بعد كيف تشغل حاسوبك الجديد؟ So another one is form 4. أشغل يشغل. To be preoccupied, to be engrossed. Such as لا تشغل نفسك بما يقوله الناس عنك مدحا أو ذما. لا تشغل نفسك بما يقوله الناس عنك مدحا أو ذما. Do not engross yourself. Do not preoccupied with what people may be saying about you. Regardless whether they are praising you or they are slandering you. هذا شغلهم. That's their job. هذا شغلهم. Don't mind them. نعم. لا تشغل نفسك بما يقوله الناس عنك. مدحا أو ذما. نعم. Now, let's move to another form. Form 7. انشغل. ينشغل. That's a verb to be preoccupied with something. انشغل. So we can say لا تنشغل بالماضي عن الحاضر. لا تنشغل بالماضي عن الحاضر. Do not be preoccupied with the past on the expense of the present. لا تنشغل بالماضي عن الحاضر. لا تنشغل بالماضي عن الحاضر. Now, another one. لا تنشغل بما قد فات عما هو قادم. Do not be preoccupied with what has passed, gone, on the expense of what is yet to come. What is yet to come is going to be greater, inshallah, God willing. The best time is on its way. Regardless of what you are or we are struggling with in life, remember, no matter how long night is, dawn is coming. لا تنشغل بما قد فات عما هو قادم. لا تنشغل بما فات قد فات عما هو قادم. Finally, let's look at form 8. اشتغل يشتغل. And that's a verb to work. So we can say, ماذا تشتغل? What do you do? To a man, to a woman, you say, ماذا تشتغلين? What do you do? وأين تشتغل? Where do you work? وأين تشتغلين? To a woman, where do you work? You can say أشتغل في, and then you can mention the place. I work at or in الجامعة, for instance, university, or المدرسة, school, مستشفى, hospital, and so on. Here we are, another root letters analyzed, and we have extracted from them the most obvious and the common theme underpinning these three letters. Sheen, Ghain, and Lam. شغل يشغل. Whenever you see those letters in that order, ignoring all the other interferences from other letters, whether at the beginning, the middle, or the end, for as long as you see Sheen, Ghain, and Lam in that order, these are the meanings, shade of meanings that you need to be looking for. Let's continue together. We'll get there, inshallah. And please, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so, and to pass this series to other people that you know that are interested in learning Arabic. Thank you so much. See you next time, inshallah. Ma'a salama ila al-liqa fi amanillah.